Speaker. The rules of this House are very clear. Before we start this session, ministers who are absent without leave must be mentioned so that we know. If they are not mentioned, we must know why they are not here. You then implore the leader of government business and the chief whip of ZANU-PF to get them here. This parliament can adjourn until all the ministers are here. The minister of education is busy sitting in his office. The deputy minister is sitting in his office. As such, today we must be serious. May this parliament adjourn until all the ministers are here, because there's no point for us to continue with question time. The minister of finance is not here. There was a monetary policy today which he must respond to. How can we continue like this? It cannot remain a circus. It is women's month, and we expect you as a woman to put this house in order. May you please rule that. I therefore move until the list of the ministers who are absent without leave is mentioned. May we adjourn until all the ministers are here. These are the rules of the House, and Madam Clerk, who is there, you know the rules of the House. The names must be read. They have not been read. So I then use the rules in the House to implore you to name all the ministers. Others are not here. It's ministers and deputy ministers. You cannot just be good in taking cars and having bodyguards. They must your coupons, and you're not here to work for the people. That's a waste of taxpayers' money. You are letting down the president every day. Where's your loyalty? Where's your loyalty? We are tired of this, Nancy. Those are the rules of the House, Madam Clerk. The list must be called, or else we adjourn. Question time only happens when ministers are here. If that list is not mentioned, then we are John talking at an end of question time. We can't continue like this. We can't continue like this. Taneta Nazir. My bodyguards now pay Muruku Piwa. Change to that Muyapana, but my deputy ministers. Ndom Temo Wacho. That list must be read. Of the ministers who are absent without leave, or else the leader of government business must be able to call them.
Take your seat, Honorable Mliswa. I've got a list of apologies from some ministers. Honorable S.B. Moyo, Minister of Foreign Affairs. Honorable M. Dlov, Minister of Environment. Honorable K. Kazembe, Minister of Home Affairs. Honorable E. Moyo, Deputy Minister of Primary and Secondary Education. And Honorable D. Marapira, Minister of State in the Vice President's Office.
Speaker, where are the rest of the ministers? They must be here. We need serious business. We cannot be joking like this. We will travel too far to come here busy wasting taxpayers' money. This parliament. Speaker, where are the rest of the ministers? They must be here. We need serious business. We cannot be joking like this. We will travel too far to come here busy wasting taxpayers' money. This parliament. Ma'am, where are the ministers who are not here? The Minister of Primary and Secondary Education has not been mentioned. He must be called. Parliament must be adjourned. He must find his way here so that he knows the power of this institution. Madam Speaker, it is Women's Month. Use that to put this house in order. We must have authority. We must have authority. We have oversight over these people. The Constitution is very clear. This is a very important institution. Education is critical right now. Why are they not here? Finance is not here again.
All right.
Honorable members, we cannot adjourn the house. Honorable honourable members can ask questions to these ministers who are present here, and I'm sure some of them are on their way coming.
Speaker, you cannot run the parliament like that. Even the Minister of Defence, who's a national person in the ruling party, who's part of the presidium, is here. What about those who are under here? We cannot run parliament like that. You must answer to my point of order, which is why are the ministers who are on the list not here? It cannot be business as usual. It cannot be business as usual. I have a right to change so contempt. The rules are very clear. If the ministers are not here, what charge are you going to give them? If it's a contempt of court of the parliament, let it be that. We are governed by rules.
Order, honourable minister.
Vakutonga kwenya mugati aiwa varipo komi vunzo inonanga vasipo inoenda kuna nimaona honorable Ziyambi vachi
kuda panze kunafonera ma ministers vasipo
osaka titaurire izvozvo.
Point of order, Madam Speaker, members of Parliament.
What is your point of order,
Madam Speaker? When we started this session, I rose twice on a point of order to say that the ministers who are mandated to run these portfolios are not here. And I do not blame Honorable Ziyambi's attitude, because he's being bombarded with things which he's not responsible for. So he's being defensive in the process. And I said, Madam Speaker, ma'am, the Honorable Minister of Finance and the Deputy were not on the list of absent with leave. They were not there. The Minister of Primary and Secondary and the Deputy were not there. I keep saying this, we are reducing this Parliament to a circus, and the monetary issues are critical to this country, and the Minister of Finance is the only one who can respond adequately to that. So where are we going? The Chief Whip says the ministers are coming, they are not here. Where are they? I'm still asking the question. You promised us that they are coming, and now we are about to finish question time. What is the point of us coming here, you know, to ask questions, to prepare questions, and the ministers are not? We cannot continue with the lead of government business all the time. We are asking with questions, we are asking with questions. You must protect him. You must feel sorry for him, because he ends up saying things which are defensive and which are not factual. It's only the ministers who are mandated in his wisdom. If the president thought he was good in finance, he could have been appointed Minister of Finance. But he's not the Minister of Finance. So why are we making him the Minister of Finance? All these positions are there. This is turning into a circus. People think we're a joke at the end of the day, because the permanent issues which are affecting people on the ground cannot be addressed by the lead of government business. So where are those ministers? I ask again. Where are those ministers who are not here? Where are the ministers? I have a right to ask this question according to the rules. You read the names of those who are not here. What about those who did not then put in their names to be absent? The Chief Whip, you said he was going there. ZANU-PF, you are the ruling party, and each opportunity which comes, okay, you must try and prove. You are losing traction. You are losing the heart of the people, because you're not responding to issues that affect people. We are here for serious business at the end of the day. We don't dress in this regalia of the lion and a hat like this to come and play games in here. We come here to ask serious questions. We are prepared for these things. We dream about these questions. We can't continue like this, Madam Speaker. And Madam Speaker, your chair can only be taken quite seriously if you are firm to these ministers. You are the boss of these ministers. They are not your bosses at the end of the day. You cannot worry about them because they're in the PB or their cabinet ministers. We are the house that has oversight over government. This is becoming a waste of time, a circus every day. A circus every day. If we cannot continue this circus when we are busy suffering, people want answers on the ground. What do we say to them? What do we say to them? The Chief Whip is supposed to phone them. Chief Whip, where are the ministers? Where is the Minister of Finance? Where is the Minister of Finance? I'm going to tell me this opportunity to talk to you. ZANU-PF has got two things. If the president is not happy with the dogs that he's hunting with, he must change the dogs and hunt with new dogs. That's how it happens. A hunter must change dogs. There are many people who are capable of doing this job. It's a waste of time. We come here, the monetary policy was announced, nothing happened. Why are we here?
Honorable,
the president is a hunter. He must hunt with his dogs. If these dogs are not able to bite, you change them as a hunter and you find those that can bite. There are so many of them who can do a job here. We are tired of this. This country is dependent on us producing results, not playing such games.